you guys right now, it's probably going to seem a little bit echoey because I'm in my new salon in, well, that is in addition to my house, and it is not full yet of stuff, so it seems a little echoey, and I've kind of been on a hiatus just a touch from YouTube because it has been so bananas for me and my family. I feel like I've been more on my Instagram game rather than my YouTube game. My life has been really crazy. There was a picture that I had posted of myself on Instagram. I was at work and I finally decided to put on some makeup, which I have done, but I don't feel like doing. But it was supposed to be something really simple, and it was really simple, and it got a lot of positive feedback from people. And they were wanting to see a tutorial, so this is it. I'll be using the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette. And I will be using a little shadow pot, I think that's what it's called. Oh yeah, it's a Super Shop shadow from ColourPop. But most of it is from the Jaclyn Hill palette. I stood in line online from my computer, my phone, and my iPad to get that palette. I think that thing sold out super, super quick, but I love it because it is geared to, well, I feel like it's geared to people with blue eyes, so most of the shadows are warm. And here you go. So I've done my eyebrows kind of already. They really need to be waxed. I'm not even gonna lie about that. And I have like my mirror and everything on like a portable table right here, so I will be turning. I also have on mascara because I did a really quick makeup thing barely this morning before church. We start with the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette. This is it. First shade that I will be starting off with though will be this one right here. So I'm going to use my Morphe M380. And when I get kind of all this down pat and what it looks like up against a blank wall, like I'll have all this down pat. But you know, I ain't a professional YouTuber, so y'all can do it to get. Especially if y'all be asking me for it. Better TV choosers. Exactly. So I'm going to start off with this one right here. I do the lighter shades first for transition purposes. And do this eye. I mean, I really wanted to have one eye done so that I would only be doing one eye on this video. But it didn't work out like that. And that is all it looks like. It's not supposed to be looking like anything extravagant or magnificent or any of those other big old words. And the next one I'm going to use is this one right here. And I stay with this brush.
This is the It Cosmetics. What is this? The It
the It Cosmetics Heavenly Luxe brush is Dualand. I really think I'm just going to use this one right here. I don't remember if that's what I use, but I'm going to use this one right here. No, it was this one. I don't have it all together, but anyways, I'm going to use this one right here. And all I'm going to do is like pat this on the lash line and kind of blend it up. It makes it look like it's smoky, but it ain't, because there ain't nothing ever be smoky. I kind of just put it right here on the lash line and pat it up. Alright, that's definitely not the color that I use, so that's going to be a big old fat line. And, or it could be, you know, maybe it is. I don't know. I don't think it is, so I'm just going to use the one that's next to it, this light purple. Use that one. And I'm going to kind of do the same thing, but keep it at the lash line, because if it's too heavy, I still got to apply to this one so that it matches. Okay, that's it. And now it looks like a big old blob, but I don't know how much of this one I'm going to blend. Ooh, brighter that works. Yeah. So, we're not done yet, but what we're going to do now is we are going to take a crease brush. This is the Morphe G17, one of my faves, and I'm going to blend all that in. That's all you have to do. And just for like dramatic effect, I always add something and kind of in the inner corner of my eye, and then just something under here to add that into the corner and to the upper part of my eye. I'm gonna use this Real Techniques detailer brush, and on my inner corner right here, I will use this shape, and you might want to keep your eyes closed so that you don't get the powder in your eyeball. And I just make that blend up into that other shade. And yep, just like that. And you gotta keep in mind, I don't have like a full face of makeup. I mean, I probably should, but I don't. And because all of this is like kind of smoky up here, I feel like there's just a little bit of something missing. So I use, yes, this is an EcoTools flatliner brush. And I use this a lot of times just to kind of give me a little bit of detail down here because it looks empty. So I'm going to use this one right here and mix in just a little bit of this right here. And just go a little under my lash line, and I pat this in. You go all the way to the kind of the inner corner where you did the pearlescent color. You know, it looks like I didn't even do anything, so that's why I'll go in with the darker color, this one right here. Be very light-handed with this because it will pick up more pigment than the other room because it's obviously a little darker in color. And that is it. This is nothing like really complicated, but for some reason it looks like it is, I promise. But I do need something up here, so I'm gonna go ahead and put this one right here. And truthfully, I don't even think I did this in that for that picture, but it's there now, and I can't go back, so. But this is really how you create it. This is all that it is. Nothing fantabulous, but here you go. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram. I have a lot more pictures on there. If you're anything like me, I love looking at pictures and just kind of seeing what people are up to. On my Instagram, I give mini clips of videos. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks.